There are many algorithms to process regular expressions. These work by implementing a construct called an automaton. At the Bell Laboratories, scientists studied these methods and their relative power and efficiency. Based on their findings, they created alternatives to grep, such as egrep, which stands for extended grep, and fgrep, which stands for fixed grep. These extensions are what we are going to learn in this unit. We can specify a precise number of repetitions by putting that range into curly brackets.
In these examples, we'll use a more powerful version of grep called egrep. Egrep stands for extended grep and supports more special characters for regular expressions. Here, I run egrep S(3) on the words dictionary to look for words with three sequential occurrences of the character S. We see in the output which words contain three consecutive S's. As another example, I want to find words with many consonants, 7 in this case. To do so, I complement the set of vowels with an upper, enclosing them in square brackets as we saw in the previous unit. Consequently, I define as a consonant anything that is not a vowel. I specify 7 occurrences of the complement set in order to match 7 consonants. We get one single word, Escholitzia. This is a North American genus of poppies named in honor of the Baltic German physician Johann Friedrich von Escholz. Within the curly brackets, we can also specify a numerical range. For instance, with comma 15, we get all words with a length of up to 15 characters. Piping the output to WC-L, we see that there are about 200,000 of them. On the other hand, with 15 comma, we get all words with at least 15 characters. Notice the regular expression I use. I type a dot for any character, followed by the set of curly brackets to specify 15 or more occurrences of this character. Around 12,000 words are matched in this case. Another special character is the plus sign. This is used to specify that the preceding element may occur one or more times. Here, 15.plus means 15 characters, followed again by one or more occurrences of any character. What's more, we can specify both a lower and an upper range bound by with a comma. Here, I look for words of a length between 15 and 16 characters. Of course, there are far fewer, about 9,000 words. Finally, the question mark is also a special character. This means that the preceding element may occur 0 or 1 times. So, it either occurs once or not at all. Specifying 15 characters, followed by any other character 1 or 0 times, is a rephrase of the above range, 15 to 16. This is why we get the same result.
We can specify references to previously matched regular expressions that we have put into brackets by using the backslash and number notation.
Consider as an example the case where we want to find all words beginning and ending with the same character. First, I use an up arrow to specify the word beginning. Then, I enclose the first character, a dot, in brackets. In this way, I can reuse the matched part later with a backslash reference. After this character, I type another dot followed by a star to include any character any number of times. At the end, I want to reuse the same character matched by the previous pair of brackets. To do that, I use backslash 1 to refer to the content matched by the first pair of brackets. The dollar special character denotes the word end. Because of head, we see all dictionary words that start and end with A and some more. Let's now look into a more interesting example. Consider the regular expression. The first and second pair of brackets match any character and store it. Then, within the third pair of brackets, I place a fourth bracket pair, which matches another character and stores it again. This last character is reused right after with backslash 4. So the third pair of brackets contains two occurrences of any character matched inside the fourth bracket pair. The following question mark means that the third pair of brackets may occur once or not at all. After the question mark, I repeat the character matched by the second pair of brackets and finish the word with the character matched by the first bracket pair. Overall, this regular expression will search for 3- and 4-letter palindromes. We can verify that from the output.
We can specify alternative matches by using the OR notation.
To see an example, here I run egrep looking for dictionary words that start with ABA or ONO, continue with anything in between, and end with LY or NE. We see the words that satisfy this regular expression. Now, for a more practical example, let's suppose that we want to check whether the current directory, dot, exists in the path variable. We've seen this variable before. It contains the directory paths where the shell looks up the commands we instruct it to execute. To check that, I first echo the contents of path, piping the output to grep. With backslash dot, I look for either an actual dot at the beginning of the path variable, or a dot between two colons. You may remember that the colon is used to separate the various path locations, or a dot at the end of the path. If the expression is true, notice the conjunction at the end, I echo current directory in path. We see in the output that this is indeed true. Incidentally, regular expressions may also be used with other commands. For instance, they can be used with the expr command to match path patterns. So, to find the miktex installation path, which is a free tech latex distribution for Windows, I run expr match on the path variable and specify a regular expression. This searches for anything, followed by a colon, followed by a backslash open bracket to start matching literal text, followed by anything but a colon, notice the up arrow in square brackets, followed by the word miktex, followed again by anything but a colon, followed by a backslash close bracket to end matching literal text, followed by a colon, followed by anything. In this way, we get the matched miktex installation path.
The commands of the grep family accept many nifty command line options.
To see some examples, I first change to the Linux kernel source code directory. A very useful option is the -L one, which lists all file names containing lines that match a regular expression. In this case, I search for the string sequence VFS in all C files, and we get the corresponding file names that match this expression. This option is especially convenient for editing files that match the pattern. We specify the output of the grep sequence as an argument to our editor. As another example, let's change to the Linux file system source code directory. I now add one more option to grep, -L, the R option, which performs a recursive search. Here, I look for all files that contain the string sequence readiter in the current directory and all its subdirectories.
A very useful option allows us to complement the match of grep so that grep will output all lines that were not matched.
Consider first this regular expression that matches block comment lines. I use a heuristic that the comment line starts with a space or a tab any number of times and then is followed by either a star or a slash star. I search for this pattern in all C files under the Linux file system source code directory, and we get some comment lines as expected. Now, I can complement this regular expression with the -V option and fetch all non-comment lines. Thus, we get all lines apart from the ones that look like C comments.
The fgrep command allows us to match fixed strings. This uses the Boyer-Moore algorithm to look for text in a very efficient manner, without looking at all characters it receives at its input.
Let's see some fgrep applications. I change again to the Linux file system source code directory. Running fgrep dot 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 on all C files, I look for an actual 3-dot sequence in them instead of 3 arbitrary characters. We see in the output a few lines containing this string sequence. As another example, I want to find all files that contain references to file metadata. These metadata are stored in structure fields which are defined in the file user include sys stat.h. The structure fields start with st underscore and continue with any character any number of times. So, to fetch these fields, I run grep on the stat.h file, specifying a regular expression with a field format. With the minus o option, we only get the matched part of each line. Next, I pipe the output to sort minus u to keep the distinct fields. These fields are then stored in a file named tmp start fields. Thus, start fields includes the structure fields of the Linux source code associated with file metadata. Now, to find all files that contain references to these structure fields, I specify the file name to fgrep after the minus f option. In this way, we get files with references to these fields, such as stdev in the first line, stino in the second, and so on. By using the nifty Boyer-Moore algorithm, fgrep performs searches very efficiently, even when specified to match thousands of possible string sequences.
This concludes our unit on selecting data with egrep and fgrep. Stay with us.